Welcome to Mastering Solutions. In this general problem, we have Brady's leap. Now, this question is one that you need to be very, very comfortable with. This is a perfect test question. In fact, it came up on my midterm test and it came up on my final test. It's a really good question because it involves multiple steps and it involves a lot of understanding for kinematics to get the correct answer. So definitely feel really comfortable with this. It's going to likely come up, or something very similar will come up. So they want to know, is this even possible? So for part A, we need to figure out what is the minimum speed that he would need to run to make it across this distance. This distance that he's jumping, they tell us, is 22 feet, and he's falling 20 feet. Let's convert this into standard units. We have it in feet, but we need it in meters. So we'll use dimensional analysis. We know we want feet down here. And let's put it into inches first. So in 1 foot, there's 12 inches. Now the feet will cancel. Now we want to put it into metric. So we'll have inches on the bottom to cancel. And on the top, we'll have centimeters. And in 1 inch, there's 2.54 centimeters. Now the inches cancel. And now in centimeters, let's change that to meters. In 1 meter, there's 100 centimeters. So now we've gone from 22 feet. We'll multiply if it's on the top, divide if it's on the bottom. So 22 multiplied by 12 multiplied by 2.54 divided by 100 gives us 6.7 meters. So this is what it is in standard units for how far he needs to jump. Before we figure out the speed, we need to figure out how long is he in the air for. So we'll only look at the y direction. So y final is equal to y initial plus initial velocity in the y direction times time plus 1/2 the acceleration times the time squared. This has come up over and over and over and over. We use this to find the time in the y direction because that will be how long he's in the air for the x direction. The initial y is 0. We'll say that right here is y equals 0. The initial velocity in the y direction is also 0. He hasn't started falling at all yet. So y final is equal to 1/2 the acceleration times the time squared. We'll multiply both sides of the equation by the reciprocal of 1/2 so that it will cancel, which is 2. So 2 times the y final is equal to acceleration times t squared. Divide both sides by a. And now we have t squared is equal to 2y final divided by acceleration. And now we'll take the square root of both sides, of course. So time is equal to the square root of 2 times the y final divided by acceleration. I know I went through that really quickly, but we have gone through that exact same process for the past I don't even know how many questions. So it should be pretty review at this point, and it should tell you that that process that we just did is most likely going to come up on your tests at some point. When we plug in our numbers here, the time that Brady is in the air for is 2 times the y final. In this case, the y that he's falling is 20, so we need to do the exact same thing for 20. So we have 20 times 12 times 2.54 divided by 100 gives us 6.1. So we have a negative 6.1 meters because it's y zeros here. So coming down here will be a negative 6.1. And we'll divide that by g because acceleration in this case is only gravity. So now the time that he's in the air is the square root of 2 times negative 6.1. And then we'll divide that by gravity, which is negative 9.8 meters per second squared. So the time that he is in the air for is 1.116 seconds. Now that we have the time, we can figure out what the speed is for him to clear this gap. We'll use the velocity equation because velocity is equal to the change in x over the change in time. And so this is already set up for what we're trying to find, the velocity. So v is equal to the distance in meters, so 6.7 meters is what he has to clear. And he's in the air for 1.116 seconds. So the velocity that he needs to clear that gap divided by 1.116 is 6 meters per second. So this is the answer for part A. What is the minimum speed he'd need to run off the edge of the cliff to make it safely to the other side? Now for B, they say that the world record time for a 100 meter dash is 10 seconds. Is that reasonable for Brady to run 6 meters per second? So for part B, we'll use the velocity equation again. We have V equals delta X over delta T. And so we have 100 meters divided by 10 seconds, which gives us 10 meters per second, is the world record speed. So is it reasonable for Brady to run 6 meters per second? Yeah, I guess. I mean, it's a little subjective. It's not like he's going 15 meters per second or something like that, which it would be definitely unrealistic. But in this case, he's going a little more than half of the world record. So yeah, that's probably pretty reasonable. So is it possible for him to do that? Yeah, it's possible and it's reasonable. He could get 6 meters per second to clear the gap.